Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Well, thank you, Jesus. Well, fine. Good to talk to you tonight about the inspirations of the Holy Ghost and how those inspirations are developed, how the flow of God is able to have free course through our life. And it is going to happen outside of our participation. You know, I love the glorious event, that first wonderful event of the baptism of the Holy Ghost and fire that you see in Acts chapter 2, verse 4. See, I had that happen to me. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon me, and I got caught away in the passions and the emotions of the Holy Ghost. Mandara day. I didn't have to try to yell. I'm going to tell you right now, and that which busted forth out of my innermost being did not hurt my throat. It did not tire me. It refreshed me. And that is the biggest contrast right there between us doing it and God the Holy Ghost doing it. Us trying to have something and moving under inspiration. Oh, when you do it under inspiration, dear people, I'm going to tell you right now, not only is it fun, but it's effective too. Hallelujah. And, you know, you're going to have to recognize this because everybody is at different places. Listen, I don't believe you have to grow into the baptism of the Holy Spirit. The baptism of the Holy Ghost and fire comes as a free gift. But what you've got to be willing to do is you've got to be willing to reprioritize your life so that you can give yourself to these things so that they become stronger and bigger and more effective. It's like the Lord just kind of like baptizes, just dumps all this glory on us and says, see, this is what you get. This is what you can have. And then all of a sudden you look around and you have less inspiration than you had at that moment. Well, you're going to have to understand how to find the inspiration. Listen, everybody gets tired. Everybody gets weary. Everybody has challenges. It's just that a few of us bust right through the thing. Huh? A few of us stand up and know how to bust through it. Not out of our human ability, but by the strength of the Lord, the power of His might, you see. We understand how to wait upon God to renew our strength. We understand how to let God the Holy Ghost take the lead. If there's anything that Father wants to see is a greater expression of Jesus Christ through our life, which is an anointing that will shake people. It'll cause them to wiggle around when you're in their midst. It'll cause sickness and disease to go out. It'll break off the mind-blinding spirits. Listen, we got to understand how to allow a greater flow of the Holy Ghost to issue forth from our life. That's not going to happen offline. That happens by your participation with the divine. Every time you sit down to read the Word of God, you're changed. Unless you're just doing it purely out of discipline and religion, it's just discipline. All it is about the minutes. Now, I believe in discipline, but relationship has to lead the way. I sit down and read the Word of God because I want to hear from God. Somebody said, how do you hear from God? Through the Scripture, through the Bible. Anybody that teaches you how to hear from God any other way, don't listen to them. You hear from God by staying before the revelation of His Word. This is the way it is. And that's what God says, and that's what I say. Anybody else says anything different, they're a liar. Okay, I'm going to agree with God because He's the only one who's true. Everybody else is a liar. Every time you participate with the Word of God, you walk away changed. You may not be able to measure it because you're so used to measuring things based upon a visible, quantitative kind of thing that you see out of your sense realm. But I'm telling you right now, spiritually you are changed. It's spirit and life. Spiritually something has been added to you. You're learning how to eat and you're learning how to drink. Every time you go to prayer, I don't care how challenging it is, especially when it's the midnight hour or the 3 o'clock in the morning hour or the 5 o'clock in the morning hour. It's a tough hour. Or what time it is. I'm going to tell you right now, or how much excitement there was every time you're changed. But you know what? If you would learn how to wait upon the inspiration, it would become far more effective through your life. Not only would it be inspirational and that much more fun, but now all of a sudden it's going to become powerful. It's going to become effective in your life. I believe that the most important thing for us to do is to recognize how the Holy Spirit is here to teach us. He wants to show us how to every day choose what God chooses. He wants to show us how to walk in the majesty of His character, to walk around as literal reproductions of his family, to be family members that look like his family, that make the same choices that he makes, that stand as the threat, not only the threat, but the means by which the satanic realm is put to flight. The armies of the alien are on they're on the run. They're in the terrifying run. Resist the devil and he will flee from you, you see. But that's just submitting yourself to God. And so it's so important for me to try to help you understand how to hook up with this inspiration. You listen to me. Little prayer, little power. It's just all the way it is. It's just the way it is. Been said for thousands of years. Nothing's changed. And I'm not talking about religious prayer. I'm talking about the prayer of the Holy Ghost. Look at how God has equipped us. My goodness, baptizes in the fire of his presence so that out of us would come forth the bursting forth out of our passions. Many people have never allowed prayer to go into their passions. It's in their throat. It's never gone into their passion. It's in their head. They're trying to think it through. And I'm going to tell you, God, the gifting of this wonderful realm of the utterance of the Holy Spirit is the place where we wait upon inspiration out of it. I mean, comes prophecy, comes the song, it comes the revelation, it comes all these things that belong to the shout. Hallelujah. And I'm going to tell you, if you want an increase in the anointing in your life, if you want to increase in the display of the power of God, even when you're talking softly, you're going to have to come to a place where God the Holy Ghost is able to inspire you to a place that it just comes up as an emotional burst, as a passionate explosion, because that's the first place where we encountered the rivers. Once again, if it's relegated to a religious exercise and you're not having fun at it, it's very difficult, you know. You've got to find the place where you make a connection with God, where it is, and listen, now there are some of us that are just hardened warriors, and there's other people that are just still sitting around in the nursery, okay? And I'm just, it isn't in any way trying to make less of you. I'm just talking about having done all to stand. I'm talking about those people who begin to cooperate with the Holy Ghost, those people who don't let a little bit of sleepy stop you. If a little bit of sleepy, a little bit of tired, a little bit of aggravation, a little bit of whatever, if you need incense and, you know, CDs and, you know, lighting and whatnot, that's just weird. You don't need that stuff. What you need is you need to begin to give yourself into an exercise of sowing into the spiritual. And there's nothing greater in terms of sowing in the spiritual than this wonderful realm of prayer where the Spirit of the Lord prays through us. And this run, because it's a life-giving surge that begins to impact every dimension of what we feel, what we want, what we need, our attitudes, our dispositions. And so the Word of God is, of course, being spirit and life and giving us the ability to know what to pray. I mean, if there's anything that I guess I probably learned more or memorized more verses of Scripture praying than anything else. But I don't stay there. OK, it is a good part of prayer. It can be a good part of prayer. It's a good part of inspiration. Oh, bless the Lord. Oh, my soul, you're going to bless the Lord and you're not going to forget all of his benefits. Lord, I'm blessing you and I'm not going to forget all of your benefits. Lord, I bless you because you're the one who daily loads me with all these wonderful things. Father God, you're the one who, you've cleansed all of my sins and all of my iniquities. You've healed all of my diseases. My, I'm just living over here in this realm of glory. But then it begins to take on a whole other dimension when you just start off, and it may start off like this. You don't got much emotion or passion there. You don't have much inspiration. But you got something. You got the that's more than you ever had. That's our miracle right there. What? I don't know what to pray. If I started praying, it might be, oh God, thank you, Lord Jesus, Holy Ghost. You know, who knows? You're just trying to figure out something to say. God's not in. Father, one thing I learned, Father is simply not impressed with adjectives, and he doesn't really need us just to be speaking something out. Huh? Dumb, but aside, just wait. What am I waiting on? inspiration. Thank you, Lord Jesus. This is, I'm telling you how to move in inspiration. I'm telling now you get rid of your CDs, your incense, and your lighting. Now you can get out of all the things that's kept you from this place, because when you find this place, I'm going to tell you right now, it's a place of refuge. It's not a place you run from. It's a place you run to. You begin to discover an affectionate realm, a glory realm that Daniel had, that he would rather be thrown to the lions than to miss one moment of it. You listen to me. Until all of a sudden, you know, the thank you, Lord Jesus, and you'll hear me. You'll always hear me. Father, I thank you for the love. I thank you for the joy. I go to give him thanks. I thank you that my name's written in the Lamb's Book of Life. I thank you that the blood of Jesus Christ has cleansed me from every stain of sin. I just go to give him thanks. I thank you for the word of wisdom, the word of knowledge, the discerning of spirits, the working of miracles, the gifts of healing, the gift of faith, hallelujah, prophecy, tongues, interpretation of tongues. I thank you for the explosion of your divine power through my life. I'm thanking him. I'm not asking him. I'm thanking him for what he's done. I'm calling him an honest one. I'm calling him truthful. I'm calling him the one who's faithful concerning all of his promises. Huh? This is what he said. It's mine. Whether I understand it or not, it's mine. I may be having to grow into it, but it's mine. I may have my daddy's shoes on. He had a size 14. At the time, I was a size 5. But I'm going to tell you right now, I'm flopping around in them. Are you listening to me? I'm thanking Father for the wonderful things that he's given. And what happens is it grows. It gets bigger. It gets louder. Not because you need to be louder, but because a river's starting to come through your passion. You're starting to get emotional by the Spirit of the Son, by the wonderful works of the Holy Ghost. Listen to me. Little prayer, little power. Little prayer, little expression of Jesus. You know, I need to tell people a lot more. Sometimes I'll just go up to people, lay hands on them, just simply say, you need to stand in the presence of the Lord more. I can tell. I can tell because there's a realm around you. And when I touch you, there's something that goes on that's even more in terms of understanding and feeling and experience that realm. If I'm living in that realm, I really know that realm. Okay, if I'm living in that realm and I come up and I touch you and all of a sudden, you know, that realm goes away, we got self-problem. I'm getting to what? Feel the feeling of your infirmity. I'm touching the feeling of your infirmity. And thus I say what? I say you need to stand in the presence of the Lord more. I don't tell you, you know what? You are just like an anti-anointing thing. It's at your presence, the Spirit of the Lord flees. I didn't ever tell anybody that. In all the things that I've been accused of being hard and harsh. No, man, I better give you the light stuff. Huh? I'm just saying, you need to stand in his presence more. Oh, rabbi. No, and I'm not saying that because it's in the sense that, you know, you're anathema or antichrist. You know, you understand what I'm saying. I'm just trying to give you an extreme expression of recognizing where you're at with response to the Holy Ghost. And what is that? It's just simply that you're not allowing the flow of heaven through your life. You're preoccupied with the flow of this life, or rather the flow of the earth, the flow of your issues, the flow of purely human thinking and realm with all of its murmuring and complaint and concern. The human realm is very negative. Has anyone noticed that? The human realm is stressed out of its mind. It's wound up tighter than a clock. I mean, I'm telling you right now, it's a sheepdog on steroids. I mean, it just constantly, you know, it's just running constantly. It doesn't know where it's going, but it's just so busy. I mean, why would you want to live in that realm? Jesus. Now, but no one wants to. But as soon as they begin to interact with the spiritual, it is an unknown realm. You don't know how to do it. You don't have the strength. You don't have the ability. It's all of a sudden, you can talk your head off when you're talking to someone, and as soon as you go to talk to God, you just shut down. All the ideas completely go. You don't have no more external stimulus to inspire you. You with me? Huh? You can't talk about how, look at that beautiful sunshine, isn't that amazing? Blah, 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 blah. The talkativeness that goes on. I mean, I've always been overwhelmed by the inspiration that people have in churches everywhere. I was in a meeting the other night, and it was relatively calm meeting. I mean, praise God for the anointing, the display of the anointing. But as soon as the place was dismissed, it was a roar of people talking to each other. Why? They're inspired and they're excited about each other. It's like, can you guys keep it down? Must you talk that loud amongst yourself? No, you can't whisper when you're excited. It's like, and everybody's doing that all at once. Well, you know what? I found the inspiration realm to talk like that to the Father. And listen, I can tell you, every great event in my life in God was always preceded by extended times of prayer. And some of that prayer was intense, challenging prayer. I mean, if you want to break through, you start fasting and praying. That's what you do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody said fasting and praying. I'm being discouraged and depressed right now. Fasting. I mean, praying is hard enough, and now you're going to put fasting into it. Oh, there's some inspiration to be found. It's a hunger realm. It's where, you know, you're always at the crossroads of hearing the call of God. You're either going to get hungry or you're going to get discouraged. Okay? Discouragement is when you look to yourself to have what God has said you can have or He's given. And hunger is when you recognize the Father wants to give it. It's already yours. Huh? All you got to do is receive. Hallelujah. Huh? That's a faith realm. And I'm going to tell you right now, everybody in this place and everybody listening to me by the web or by the YouTube right now, God has given you a measure of faith. What are you going to do with it? You can sit and listen to the lies of Satan. You can sit and listen to all the things that will swamp your head. My goodness, if I had a mind thinking like some people do, I would just stick my face in the Bible and read till my mind was so washed I can't think anymore anything other than the Word of God. Because I'm going to tell you right now, people who have long extended periods of time where they can't get delivered from harassment and torment and sin and iniquity, you've got yourself a relationship problem. Your heart's not right with God. God is easy. I mean, I was thinking about Hezekiah. He was rude. Rude. You know, Isaiah comes walking in and says, you know, you're going to die and not live. What a terrible thing from the prophet. You're going to die and not live. Set your house in order. So, the prophet turns around and walks out. You know, that's the way they are. You know, they don't show you a whole lot of affection and love and pat you on the back and say it's going to be all right. When you see Jesus, say hello for me. Amen. Prophets don't do that. And so Hezekiah set his face to the wall and he began to cry out to God. Oh, Lord, remember my faithfulness to you. Remember, I walked uprightly before you with a perfect heart. Oh, God, I want to live. And so Isaiah hadn't even gotten out of the palace yet. God said, go turn around, tell him, and give 15 more years, okay? So, yeah. I mean, Father is so easy. I mean, how quickly did he hear? That's how quickly he always hears. He always hears that quickly. There will be hindrances that will stop you from getting your answer to prayer, just like you read about in Daniel. And even though the spiritual realm has changed since Daniel's day, you still got your issues. And especially if you haven't learned how to walk in the realms of the Spirit and mind the things of God, especially if you open up the door to a satanic realm who wants to shut down the manifestation of the anointing and has a right to. You listen to me. Oh, yeah, there's a contest going on. Never stop. Didn't stop with Job. Didn't stop at the cross. It's going on with you right now. You got to decide what you want. I'm telling you, it's a privilege to be trained to walk in the behavior and the manner and the authority of the living God, to learn how to choose what He chose, to learn how to do what He does, to make His decisions. What do you think, son of man? What do you believe we should do? Look at the partnership Father has with the people on the earth who's willing to go with Him, not religiously, but relationally, willing to make it bigger than something that is just simply about them, but it's about the whole of His creation. Come on. Huh? And then Hezekiah's got to go get rude. God comes in, tells him, okay, you got 15 more years. You answered your prayer so quickly. Yeah, put some figs on the boil. You'll be healed. Prophet gives, you know, prophet gives the word of the Lord. Somebody say, I'm old figs, a remedy for boils. No, only by the word of God. Only by the word of God. The Lord will tell you to put salt in your eye, sneeze twice or whatever, you know. Whatever God says, you do it. Go dip in the Jordan 7 times. Go wash in the pool of Siloam. Put a fig on your boil. Whatever He says, you do it.
And then Hezekiah has got to be rude. He's got to go, how will I know? Give me a sign that this will be true. If I was God, I'd say, well, just forget about it, man. I'm done. I'd have walked back out. But no, Father, he's so easy. He's so loving. He goes, well, what do you want me to do, man? What do you want me to do? What do you want? Well, what kind of proofs do you need that I've healed you? Goodness, that's rude. And he says, the Lord says, what do you want me to do? You want me to cause the sundial to go forward 10 degrees, or you want me to go backwards 10 degrees? And then Hezekiah's got to be more rude. Well, it ain't nothing for it to go forward 10 degrees. I want to go back. I mean, my goodness, and Father does it. That's prayer. That's interaction. That's requesting. That's calling. That's talking to him in such a way. This is how Father wants Jesus to be glorified. This is how prophecy begins to be developed in your life. This is how word of wisdom, revelation, knowledge, doctrine. Somebody says, how do you know that what you're saying is what God is saying? Because I was born again. And I was given a new heart that is one with his heart. And I was given a new spirit that's one with his spirit. And I said to the trash, get out of here. Okay? Now I'm over here with him. I'm bathing in his word. I praise God. I'm sitting there before the word of God and before the revelation of the word of God. And I'm receiving the things that are bigger than I could ever think. I'm receiving that which God understands and which God knows. And my spirit is joined unto the Holy Ghost. And so now, because in this relationship, whatever he feels, I feel. What I'm feeling is what he's feeling. If I'm feeling bad about you, he's feeling bad about you. Uh-oh. If I'm feeling good about you, he's feeling good about you. Huh? If I feel like speaking about you need to be born again, that's what he's thinking that you need to hear. Huh? I just live under the inspiration. Now, somebody says, well, you know, you just live under the inspiration. You don't have any work to do just from one inspiration to the next. No. I give myself continually to that realm that I might be hooked up with him, that I might be trained by him, that I might think his thoughts. Can you hear what I'm saying? I'm in his word. I'm just bathing myself in his word. I love his word. I'm going to tell you right now, you know, it's hard to eat when you don't have an appetite. Why? You don't have the inspiration. Are you listening to me? But I'm going to tell you right now, you begin to cry out to God and say, Father, I got myself a spiritual sickness and disease. My spiritual sickness and disease would cause me physically to die in a very short period of time. And so, Lord, I want you, come heal my spiritual disease. And you know what God does? He does that. He comes and heals you. But there will be times where we pray and we ask Father to do something, and he's not going to be necessarily going to respond real quickly, because he's going to try us. He's going to see whether, because God wants us to talk with him with a boldness and a confidence, knowing that he is who he says he is. See, Abraham had no problem offering up Isaac, doing whatever God told him to do, because he had a relationship with God. Coming out of that relationship, he came to understand how God is so full of love and generosity and how good God is. He knew he could trust God with anything. Are you listening to me? Yeah. So when you know that, you can have a petitioning prayer that continues to come to the judge and weary the judge by your much coming. Hallelujah. You know, you're going to stand there and you're going to bang and you're going to knock and say, I said, get up. Hey! I said, hey! Hey! And when's the last time you prayed like that? When's the last time you had the inspiration? Because that's kind of Holy Ghost inspiration that you can receive from this realm. Hallelujah. And it's what God wants. And he has the right to see whether or not it's going to get in our passions, whether we want it enough to it becomes more of an emotion than the other things of this earth that you're excited about. Because Father looks. He looks. He stands there and listens and says, man, when they were praying, you know, you could have heard a mouse whisper. Huh? And that was louder than a whisper of a mouse, but you know what I'm saying? You could hear, when they were praying, you could have heard a pin drop. Now, when they're talking to me, you could hear a pin drop. Now they're talking to one another, and you need earplugs. You need earmuffs to buffer the sound. It's so loud. Father sees that. Does it have an impact? Yeah, it has an impact. He's going to try you and prove you. So, well, okay, when are you going to get some boldness in it? When are you going to get some persistence in it? When are you going to get some confidence in it? When are you going to have assurance, confidence, expectation? Because those are the ingredients of faith. How are we going to let God develop us? Are we going to be willing to go through some of the things that other champions that he raised up went through? The things that Abraham went through. The things that Enoch went through. The things that Abraham went through. The things that that Moses went through. The things that Job went through. I mean, come on. You know. My Father has so equipped us. He's lavished us with divine ability to be able to learn how to walk in this realm. You know, I hear people all the time talking about, oh God, I want greater anointing. Oh God, I want to be able to do this. Oh God, I want to be able to do that. And he's like, good. This is exactly what I want for you. Yeah. But then it doesn't go very far. Now, let me just say, there is something about the church that is so powerful and you want to take advantage of it. Yeah. Because I'm going to tell you right now, you can pray better in here than you can pray in your living room. You know why? Because there's a realm of divine grace in here in the place because it's his church. Hallelujah. You don't believe his church? I'll line up a bunch of people to tell you this is his church. That no. Amen. It's his church. And where his church is, there is a grace. All his fullness is there. That's why you want to come learn how to pray. I've had years of people sitting around watching me pray. Say, this is very fascinating. When is he going to tire? I've had people sit 8-10 hours, watch me pray. When will he tire? And I won't. If I'm fasting and praying, if you've ever been around with me fasting and praying, I pray. And you know what? There's not a lot of silence with me praying. I'll get after the program. Why? I'm getting refreshed. I'm not into competition who can breathe the best, who can talk the longest and the loudest. No, I found a realm of inspiration. How did I get into it? I got baptized in the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. And I thought it was so good, I couldn't stop. I mean, it was shouts, it was rejoicing, it was crying, it was sambalakiste paranambalea, it was hallelujahs, it was glory divines. And my throat wasn't sore after it. I shouted more than I'd ever shouted at any other thing where my throat got sore after doing it for an hour and a half, 2 hours. Right? But here I am caught away in glory. Ooh, rabasate pikadast. No, there are times, and you know, really I can access this realm anytime where I have a built-in PA system. It will come out. It will be so strong in my belly. It will sound out. I mean, the loudness of the voice of God coming out of my innermost being. Where did I find that? I got baptized in the Holy Ghost and fire. Hallelujah. I had Pentecost. It's just one small part of Pentecost. And so in that place, then I discovered, well, you know, there are going to be challenges and there are times where I try to pray early in the morning. I couldn't pray. My wife, my blessed wife, I used to tease her about it, but I don't really kneel and pray. I don't kneel because not often my legs, my knees don't like kneeling. I like to be up moving around. I like dancing, okay? And she can go put that prayer mat that she's got, that prayer cushion, she puts that thing down. You know, I find her in the closet somewhere kneeling down. I'm like, it's a Catholic thing, you know. No, it wasn't. It was. It's her thing. It's where she makes connection with the Lord. And it gets glorious, okay? Now, there are things that I could help her with to where that there is a greater explosion of the expressions of divine utterance through her life, okay? And what we do is we just, and she has that. But there's things that if she would just do what I do and follow me around a little bit more, that thing that she desires to have would be in her, but she's got to modify the way she connects. Now, I'm going to walk in there and go, I tell you right now, I'm sick and tired of you being, you know, what you are. Get up! Follow me around. That's not, you can't do that. Just let people do what they want to do. The most important thing is, are you making a connection with heaven? Now, what's going to happen is you're going to come to a place in your life that you're going to get desperate. You say, I want more of that. How can I have that? Yeah. Huh? Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Fuck out, I must say it. I look at Enoch, I want more of that. Yeah. I look at Jesus, I want more of that. Yeah.
There's not a lot of people that I look around in this life and go, I want more of that. It's like, I don't want any of that. No, thank you. Hallelujah. There was one time I had a, sometimes I need help. I had a person, a very famous person, said he wanted to come be a part of this church and, you know, and be here in the meeting. And a friend of mine called me up and said, there's nothing he has you want. So if he wants to come there, just tell him, just come there to learn. There's nothing he has you want. And I thought, because I didn't really think that at first, because there's a particular gifting. I love the word of knowledge, and this particular person was very accurate in the word of knowledge. But the reality of it is sometimes we've got to sort out, what do we want? Do we want an activity, an action, a deed, a power? Or do we want the glory? Do we want something that causes us to step over into a deeper realm of interacting with the person of the living God, learning his behavior, being fortified with his character and his nature, to where we stand up and take unto ourselves the whole armor of God, and Satan runs in fear of us? I want that part. I want to be able to deal with every demonic thing. Hallelujah. Yeah. Temptation comes at me. You see, I'm not stupid anymore. I used to be stupid. I was saved, but I was stupid. Hallelujah. Saved and stupid. Now I'm not ignorant of the devices. I know what happens. As soon as God is about ready to explode something through my life that is going to affect people, Satan comes at me with everything he can come at me. He'll come at me with a virus, sickness, temptation that I've never even had to deal with. Just come at me, just press it on me. Before it's like, what's happening to me now? I'm backslidden. I'm melting. Where is my relationship with God? I didn't know how to respond to the oppressive power of darkness, where Satan launches a fortified attack to say, I'm going to prove to you he has no right to represent you. He will not walk in your realm. He will not make your choices. You have no right to empower him on such a level. Yeah, you listening to me? Come on. God, Father has given us the mantle and privilege of being able to live out his life, and there's a responsibility therewith, and there's a whole bunch of principalities and powers looking and making various different decisions around it. And God's got laws. He's got spiritual laws of life, and he loves us, and he's going to continue to work with us. I'm an example of that. He's going to continue to show forth all kinds of mercy and all kinds of grace, but he's going to say, someday you're going to have to stand up and recognize that those powers of darkness are there to stop the flow of my divine power and glory through your life on a greater level. Hallelujah. Listen to me. And you're going to quit. You're going to suddenly say, wait a minute. I'm not going to live for my own pleasure. I'm going to live for his pleasure. I'm going to call the holy thing sacred. And then I'm going to delight myself in the Lord. Then I'm going to ride upon my high place. Then I'm going to eat the good heritage of Jacob. I'm going to be fed with all the blessings of heaven. You listening to me? People just don't get it. They don't get it because Satan will come at you. He'll come at you with everything he can throw at you, whether he's going to get you with offenses or whether he's going to get you with a virus or whether he's going to get you with discouragement. I'm telling you, I probably have had to deal with and battle discouragement and battle that whole realm of, you know, what am I doing wrong kind of thing, more than probably anything else. And of course, when you are a person of destiny, you know, the call of God's upon your life, and everybody that you see tells you it, and you seem like you're stuck, as frustration if you don't know how to properly deal with it. So whatever it is that you're having to deal with, and for the whole gamut of things, from the lust of the flesh to the lust of the eye to the pride of life, and what I was just talking about really finds its force and dimensions within the pride of life, or just in the realms of doubt and unbelief, okay, which I could actually make them almost as separate categories, okay? But nonetheless, people, I'm going to tell you, if you'll begin to say, wait a minute, I'm no longer ignorant concerning Satan's devices. I recognize that Father has given me spiritual authority. He's given me the weapons of my warfare. He's given me the privilege of going and really building myself up in the Most Holy Ghost, building myself up in the faith by the study of the Word, receiving divine inspiration from the Word. See, the Word of God was not only spoken by inspiration, it imparts inspiration. The Word of God actually comes and brings divine strength and divine power and divine ability. It allows you to see clearly. It refreshes you. It's food. It awakens you. It's food, spiritual food that strengthens you. Yeah. It gives you the ability to take off running. Yeah. We were just fasting at the first of the year. In the first couple of days, I was moving real slow because I was just weak. Huh? But my goodness, your body get used to that different kind of diet and you have more movement. But by the time, and I had a supernatural fast, so I wasn't hungry. I was weak, but I wasn't hungry. And that's something you grow into, people. That's something you mature into. Because I'm telling you right now, when you start fasting and you say, I'm hungry after the first few missed breakfasts, this must not be God. No. That just because you don't know what you're doing yet. Hallelujah. You just need to grow in the things of the Spirit. Give yourself to growing in the things of the Spirit. And what happens though, but when you finish, then afterwards you're hungry. And I actually wasn't hungry. I just started eating. I started eating because I was just, I had so many things going on, so many schedules. I mean, I just had a person call me up from India, has a huge church ministry, says, we want you to please come to India. We're setting up a crusade. There'll be 20,000 to 30,000 people. We're paying for everything. You land here. All you got to do is land here. We're paying for everything by the time you get here. So what happens is there comes a critical moment in time in your life, and one thing after another, boom, 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 you can't keep up with it all. And I already knew that those things were going to start happening this year, so I said, well, I'm going to start eating a little bit. But as soon as I took food, poof, I'm strong, just so strong, man. I just, that refreshing. Well, to me, that's the same way it is with the Word. People go long stretches without the Word, and then when they go to the Word, it's kind of like, can I be any more bored? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's not a communion or relationship thing. Don't even pick up the Bible till it's a relationship. Don't even pick it up. Yeah. Yeah. Just forget about it. Go drink a beer. Go cuss somebody out. You know what I'm saying? Get it black and, what I'm saying? Get it right down to the reality. Truth or lie. Yeah. Truth or lie. Death or life. God or Satan. Come on, man. Yeah. You with me? Because people live such compromised lives, they don't even know what they're doing. Huh? Get your heart right. Don't you pick up that holy realm just because it's some religious thing. Say, Father, I want to know you. Lord, get my heart. You ask him, get my heart right. Of course, I don't want nobody to go drink a beer. I don't want anybody to cuss anyone out. I'm just saying that because that's really the attitude or disposition. It's opposite to the realms of God. And that's what you're going to be doing to some degree or other. I mean, may not be those particular ones, but you'll have some going on. I guarantee if you're not full of the Holy Ghost, your mind is a ping pong, table. Huh? And one devil's on one side and another devil's on the other. And it's a ping, 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 back and forth. It is. Huh? Frustration's playing on one side, and aggravation's on the other. Jesus, help us. Come on over into the good life. Father wants to develop us an inspiration. And one of the things about singing, I mean, to be able to shout unto the Lord. I'm looking, when the music goes off, I'm looking for inspiration. If I start playing a song or singing a song, if I don't feel the inspiration, I'll shut it down. I'll just shut it down, go back to praying in the Holy Ghost, take another run at it. Are you listening to me? I don't feel obligated to do anything but to touch that realm. I want that realm. And I believe with all of my heart that the tongues, that the utterances of the Holy Ghost is supposed to lead in that expression and lead in that realm. I'm not saying that the Word of God can't give inspiration. It came by inspiration and it will give inspiration. But I am saying that Father has given to us the same power that breathed forth the Word. The Word of God came as Holy Ghost filled men spoke under the inspiration of Almighty God. Hallelujah. And that same inspiration, that same life-giving power flows into us. So really what I want to get at tonight with you is I want to get you to a place where you just, you know, force it. You force it, it's going to get worse. You stress out about it. You try to have something that's given to you. Well, give me a break. You can't enforce it. You can't make it happen. You take what Father has given to you, and you're faithfully coming before His presence because you want a greater flow of the anointing in your life. You want a greater flow of His presence in your life. You want to know Him like you've never known Him. You want to be obedient to Him. You want to participate with Him. You want to cooperate with Him. And here's what you know. And here's what you have, and you bring it, and you go with it. And you just go with the thanksgiving, go with the praying of the word, whatever it is. Father is going to see the heart, and what He's going to do is He's going to begin to explode that on the inside of your life. But what you want to be going after is you want to be going after divine expressions that fill your passions and your emotions that begin, that's hard to shut off. You want to find a realm of prayer that's hard to stop. Hello. Somebody said, well, where do I find that? In church. Right here. We're doing it all the time. Well, I just said that. As long as you've got an excuse, there's nothing going to happen. Huh? The enemy will take great advantages of that excuse. You're not playing my song. I always do great. I do great on How Great Thou Art. If you could just start singing How Great Thou Art, then I can start feeling the inspiration. Huh? You know, Jesus. That's okay for the first two times. Okay? Maybe. But we can't have you addicted to how great thou art. And that's how you hook up with the Holy Ghost. Huh? Are you listening to me? Amen. We want you dependent upon the Holy Spirit. Father's looking for those to worship Him that way. That's what He's desiring. He's looking. And worship is a way to express relationship. Praise is the way to express relationship. As soon as praise starts coming on, as soon as there's an interaction of love, it's an expression of love. He inhabits that. He's just like, woo! You know, He comes and starts dancing around, starts rejoicing. All of His desires are with the sons of men. Isn't that amazing? Isn't it amazing that He wants to be with you? Isn't that amazing? It's amazing. It's amazing. You might not want to be with you, but He wants to be with you. I mean, there are people, I don't believe there's anybody here that's like that tonight that is that depressed. Because that's a serious depression. Mm-hmm. So amazing. Father, so amazing. It is a huge impact on your faith when you know how much He wants to be with you. When you begin to recognize that Christ Jesus, that the Holy Ghost is not going to be able to be expressed through you until you learn how to participate with Him so that He can speak through you, pray through you, worship through you, sing through you. And the more that He has that liberty, we're giving Him liberty, then those water courses are developed, as it were. There becomes, as it were, a greater and a deeper flow and a deeper expression. I pray very differently than I did when I was baptized in the Holy Ghost 35 years ago. Are you listening to me? And is different. It is the realms of the expressions of the kingdom of God that have great diversity. And did you know I just interpreted what I spoke? Okay. So good, it's good, because I was just meeting with someone and he was telling me, you know, I just discovered that the same inspiration of the tongues, I was interpreting my tongues last night. I said, yeah, it's just that easy, it really is. Just the same inspiration. He said it was just, I could feel the same glory, the same feeling that you have under the anointing of the tongues. Yeah, it's just really that easy. And so there is a tongue, there is a there is a language when I'm praying for people for different things. When I'm dealing with demon power, when I'm dealing with opposing things in the realms of the spirit, it's a tongue. There's a specific tongue. And here's a beautiful thing. As soon as today, for example, here's a beautiful thing. I sat down at the computer because I'm having to find some images that I need that for my book. And as soon as I sat down at the computer and I started going over these images, there's a particular type of tongue that comes out of me that builds me up, says, get ready, something's getting ready to pop up here. So the stata mongoliam, a specific type of tongue that prepares me for temptation or to deal with some kind of a satanic assault. Well, when I know it, I'm already on guard. Okay, next, we don't let's go next then. Something's getting ready to happen. That same kind of tongue will come upon me. We're making intercession to pray for somebody. I know, oh, this is an intercession tongue. And you say, well, how do you know that? Because it's time at task. Oh, I want to know that. I want to know. Do you really want to know that? Do you really want to have that? Get busy. Get hungry. Start pursuing a relationship with God that isn't going to cost you half as much as what you've been spending on yourself. It ain't going to cost you a fraction as much as all you put in to your job and to your school and to all the other stuff that you're interested in. Huh? People put a lot of energy into stuff. Listen to me. You put a lot of energy putting your baby in your little stroller and walking around the lake. Talking about the sun, the moon, the stars, and whether it's going to rain next year. I tried my best to make it look as rejected as possible. Why don't you take and put that over in the seeking of the Lord? Why? Because, see, that is locked down in a natural realm where we become very comfortable. We're very accustomed to that. The response factors of your body are good with that. Now you're going to come up to an unfamiliar territory that has no external stimulus, no things that normally you go for your little rewards, dessert after the green beans or whatever. You know what I'm saying? All the things that you get out of it. I'm going to talk, but I'm going to talk, you know, to impress you, to then hear you talk some good things back to me. Then I'm going to talk some more things to you to get some more things. And it's the weirdness of humanity. Now we're going to come up against, and I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that particular weirdness. It's the social behavior of men. And praise God that there's people that are friendly and kind. And I guess you got to talk about the weather and you've got to talk about things to some degree. I don't, but I guess people have to. Majority are doing it. But then when you come over here to this unseen realm, who are you dealing with? What are you interacting with? I'm interacting with somebody on the inside of me. I'm not doing this. Now where are you? I'm not trying to think something up. Oh God, speak to me. Speak. I still can't hear. I still speak. He's in here. It's a miracle to me. And he begins to come up out of the innermost being. He begins to flow out of me and feels the place. Hallelujah. No. I recognize he's right here with me. But first and foremost, people, he's in you. He's in you. Just starts talking truth. God gets excited about truth. God the Holy Ghost hooks up with truth. You start talking a bunch of nonsense, a bunch of trash. Huh? Oh, I'm just...
I can't do nothing. Failure. Don't know what's wrong with me. Really, you're saying I don't know what's wrong with you, God, but I'm gonna leave that. Can't pray. Can't please the pastor. Dog's mad. You know, you're not going to feel any inspiration here. God the Holy Ghost is not going to be anywhere near it. Start talking some truth. Huh? I mean, the power and the glory of God. I'm going to tell you something. Listen to this. This is a shock to you. Because this is taking it to the extreme, okay? I'll give you an extreme example. A person came to me one time and they said, you know, why do you preach so harsh and so intense? I said, because when I do, the manifest glory comes. This person looking at me, he said, are you sure? I said, well, let me ask you a question. Do you feel the manifest glory in the meetings that you've been here? He said, yeah, I have. I said, it's because of the preaching. So you take away what I'm saying, you're not having that manifest glory. Papa's excited about me getting all over you. Yeah. Straightening you out. Because he's looking for somebody who's going to do it right. Yeah. And quit compromising all this stuff. He's looking for somebody who's got an uncompromised radical truth statement that says about you need to change and you need to change right now. Yeah. And every bit of you, not some of you, all of you. Kind of thing. Yeah. Holy Ghost moves in on that. Yeah. Huh? Now the people who didn't like that. No, I'm not saying that about you. The people who didn't like that, they may have been sitting there feeling nothing. Huh? Potentially. Because they're not going to hook up with the truth. If you're going to begin to feel and experience the inspiration and the manifest presence of the Lord, speak truth. God the Holy and God the Holy Ghost has come to teach us truth, but fundamentally it's the Word of God that teaches us that truth. And so I get to speak out of that realm, out of the Word. If I'm not speaking the Word of God, my goodness, then you know, I'm not going to be anywhere even in the general vicinity of where God is. How am I going to learn how to do that? You have to give yourself to the Word. That's where he'll train you. So it's just like I was saying with Samuel. There he was. He's laid there before the revelation of God's presence, which was represented by the light in the holy place, which he was supposed to manage and keep lit. And what ultimately came out of that is he spoke so perfectly on behalf of Father that, you know, and I'm going to put it that way, that he spoke so perfectly on behalf of the Father, because simply the Lord did not let one single word that he spoke fall to the ground. In other words, everything he said came to pass.
Yeah.
And it's almost like whether it was what Father was thinking or not, the Father just appealed it. Because he made him a partner and he was willing to be a partner and go all the way with him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I want just to help you, just talk to you for a minute about finding inspiration. Feeling the inspiration of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Pondoro siti. Perestukuri nivishi. And just enjoying his presence. And finding in a place of acceptance with him, because the Word of God has declared something to you that he's given you faith to believe. And you've shut out all the other nonsense that says it's not true. Are you going to have to play king on the hill with condemnation, accusation, shame, and guilt? Huh? You know what king on the hill is? Right? It's where you take the high spot and everybody starts coming at you to try to knock you off, right? And just throwing everybody around. Maintaining your spot. Right? Anybody else play that besides me? Okay, good. Just checking. It's in the realms of the thoughts. But you won't have to do that for long. But what happens if you just meditate in that realm? You got the wrong kind of inspiration. You're going in the wrong direction. Hallelujah. You know, one of the names for the Holy Ghost is security. He brings security. He comforts. He brings security.
we begin, God will give us such a strong sense of self-worth, because all of our self-worth is in Him, that we don't ever be offended again. We're so secure, we're not even offended. Nothing bothers us. We're so filled up with Him, our whole life is about touching other people and blessing them. We don't need anything from anybody. We got everything you know what? We got everything we need. It's like going to somebody's house and you just ate. You're full. It doesn't matter how good it smells. Doesn't matter what kind of stuff's coming down with it. You're full. I couldn't eat another bite. Well, man, I've got I've got strawberry shortcake here with all of the stuff and, homemade honey ice cream. And we made the shortbread ourselves, all organic, and they give you the whole thing. Look, I'm full. I'm stuffed. I'm full. I can't. I promise you, I can't eat another thing. Well, the Lord wants us to be so filled that we don't need anything. We're just about giving. We're just continually so filled. We don't even care about whether anybody loves us anymore. It doesn't even matter. You can't even be in the ministry if you're concerned about whether or not people love you. Because you'll die after the first month. Do you still love me? Do you still like me? Could you please send out an email request to tell everybody if yes, check yes. If no, don't say anything because I can't take it. No, you just don't even care about whether anybody loves you. You got all the love you can handle, man. I'm loaded down with so much love I can't even hardly move. I'm about giving love. That's all I'm interested in. Lord, am I moving into love? Am I showing your love? Hallelujah. All that's got to change. Next time you hear somebody tell you, oh, there's not enough love in the place, you know exactly. What you need to do is say, can I pray for you? And the prayer is all about now, you look at them, you say, we want you to find all that you have need of in your relationship with Jesus from this day forward. Because you're looking for love in the wrong places. You could actually grab the guitar and start singing it. Looking for love in all the wrong places. Hey, you're not going to find it there. You're never going to be happy. You're going to be disgruntled. You're going to be a mess. You're going to be a leaven in the house. A root of bitterness springing up and defiling many. I'd hate to think of myself as a root of bitterness. Wouldn't you hate that? You don't even want that. And you don't ever have to have that. All you got to do is want to be right with God. You know how you know you want to be right with God? Because everything anybody tells you to do, you'll do it. Huh? Hallelujah. Today, we were out exercising, and my wife said, honey, let me take your shirt. I said, well, you're not taking my shirt, because I took a shirt off. It's hot. I had a t-shirt on underneath it. I wasn't exposed. She said, let me take your shirt. I said, you're not my slave. She said, oh, yes, I am, voluntarily. I said, baby, I'd be a tyrant if I let you be that. I know you are, and that's good, but I'd be a tyrant. Huh? If I let that. See, look, dear people, there is always a reciprocation going on between the house, between each other. But come on, and there's never going to be the taking advantage of servitude. It just doesn't even exist. Huh? It's just beautiful. Somebody's too worried about somebody going to take advantage of them. You're not even anywhere near the zone called servitude. You're still in the place called Lord, Baal. The Baalites. Now, there has to be a distinction. Paul made that distinction. Are you belong to the Lord or you belong to Baal? Are you sitting at the table of the Lord or are you sitting at the table of devils? We got to have that sorting out. Because we can't allow all this stuff. Here I'm talking about the glories of heaven. Here I'm talking about this flow of divine inspiration. Here I'm talking about all these wonderful and good things that Father would supply to us and develop in our lives. But we can't be taking in a bunch of trash. We can't be participating with a bunch of iniquity. We can't be participating with that which is out to destroy the anointing and shut the anointing down. You and I need to get passionate about Jesus being revealed through our life. That's it. And I'm telling you right now, that will change nations. Yeah. That will shape the context of the church to be what God wants it to be. We just begin so earnest about the Holy Spirit being fully revealed through our lives. That's it. Yeah. And it's that right there at the moment of the crisis, the moment of the temptation, the moment when the enemy is bombarding you, the moment when you feel tired and you feel weak. How does that strength, how do you begin to become developed in the strength of the Lord and the power of His might unless you're giving yourself to a good spiritual diet? It's the diet of champions. Amen. Hallelujah. It's the diet of the mighty. Hallelujah. It's the word of the Lord. Huh? It's the drink of prayer. It's the drink of the Holy Ghost. It's this mositara mate apurasita. Hallelujah. So if you were here in the meeting earlier, you know, the prayer meeting was a Holy Ghost meeting. The Holy Ghost meeting. Now, you could enter in or you could not enter. And I heard Thursday night that the whole building was shaking. Yeah. Because you guys were praying up there. Come on, man. Come on. See, you can get into a Holy Ghost meeting. You can begin to lay the foundation for Holy Ghost meetings in your life and then in the church and in the community and the groups that you meet. You create an environment. You lay a foundation. That foundation is this passionate interaction with God, this thing called prayer. Huh? You begin to toil, you begin to work and till the soil. Huh? And yeah, it's work. It could be work, but it's fun. Huh? And especially when you're hooked up with the realms of the Spirit. Oh, bade bate shekoya patare. And I tell you, people, it's so easy. It's so easy in this place. You know, I started having meetings, counseling meetings today at 4:00. I was already tired. I've been just putting a lot of hours into the things that I'm finishing up with this book and other things, and you know, and so by the time I came walking down the stairs, I was tired. I was just tired. I was weary. So you know, when you're weary like that, you know what you can easily do? You can easily go with what your body dictates. Now there was a time in my life that I would do that, but then I realized that my spirit was greater than my body. I understood that my inner man, my spiritual man, had a greater authority than my physical man. And that if I would begin to rise up in this realm, I could deal with tiredness. When I learned how to deal with tiredness, I learned how to deal with sickness. When I learned how to not let tiredness rule me, sickness couldn't rule me. So then I stood up there and I'm just really tired and I'm just walking back and forth. And praise God, there was a few people in here praying. What am I waiting for? What am I looking for?
Inspiration.
That's right, I'm looking for inspiration. Praise God, I got stuff. I know where to start. I've been baptized in the Holy Ghost. It's always there. It's ready for me. All the time, anytime. Ready. I'm showing you how to do this. I'm not bragging on myself. I'm showing you how to do this. I'm going to show you how to do this again. Because this is the school of the Spirit. This is where the Holy Ghost trains us. Somebody said, what if you don't have the language of the Spirit? Just go ahead and start. Just go ahead and get it. Right now. Because the only person don't want it is you. You're the only one, but you're the only person keeping you back from it. Because God ain't keeping you back from it. The devil is not allowed. Huh? And now, because I am devoted to excelling, I'm devoted to excelling. I'm not going to stay there. I'm devoted to excelling. Okay? Well, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to obey God's word. I'm going to pray the Spirit and I'm going to pray the understanding also. Are you with me?
Yes.
I'm going to pray the truth though. I'm not going to go, oh God, I'm so tired. Lord, would it be okay? Would it be all right with you if I just don't do the meeting tonight? If I just go ahead and slip out and call somebody else up and let them take it? Can you hear me? Because there's various different iterations of that same theme. Lord, it's just okay if I just go ahead and go to bed early tonight and I just don't pray. Are you listening to me? Oh, Lord, you know, I got all this other stuff I got to do. You know, this workload that I've got to get. I'm sure you don't mind if I go ahead and do my math homework. Because you're not going to get, you're building something else. You're giving yourself to something else. You're copping out.
True.
Get a backbone.
Come on.
Come on, get some strength.
Yeah.
Yeah. Come on. Come on. Yeah. Come on. Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah. Come on. Get in the game.
Yeah.
Get in the fight. Come
yeah.
on.
Come on.
Go big or go home.
Come on.
And home's heaven.
Yeah.
So,
We know what we're doing here. We know that we're going to be changed by this. I am so hungry for the anointing of the Holy Ghost to be expressed through my life in a greater way. I know that this is where I'm going to get changed. That is motive enough. This is where I'm going to be strengthened. This is where I'm going to be developed. I don't want to be taken out by Satan another time, not another sickness, not another disease, not another sin, not another failing, not another shortcoming. And I know that this is where this is all worked out. I may not be able to understand. I might not be able to measure it at that moment, but I know. But fortunately now, I've grown enough that I can measure it because of the manifest presence of the Lord. Huh? But because I like to excel in my mind, I'll just start saying, thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise your holy name. Thank you, mighty God. You know what that is? Do you know what all that is? Truth. Truth. We're going somewhere here. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, living God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Anybody can say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Everybody can say thank you, Jesus. Everybody can say praise God. We're moving. We're going somewhere. We're going higher heights. We're pressing into a realm. Hallelujah. We're not struggling with it. We're just here. We're doing what Father has requested us to come and do. And I'm going to tell you right now, He's going to inhabit that. He's going to meet us. It's going to be an explosion in our life. It's going to be a divine event. And especially if we will not weary in well-doing, we're going to reap something big. And I'm telling you, the context about that is spiritual things more than it is financial. I'd rather have heaven's glory and gifts and anointing and virtue than money any day. Let me be in poor and poverty and rags and have the glory of heaven. Well, I'm going to tell you right now, you can't have the glory of heaven and not be blessed. I mean, the animals will be bringing you food. I tell you, the lambs will come offering their skin for clothing. I mean, And then you'll feel a shift. Then you start feeling the sleepy starting to go away. I'm waking up over here. And then it gets stronger. I'm going for stronger. I'm going for excel. I'm not going for something that is loud that I'm doing out of my own human ability. I'm going after inspiration. I want you tonight to leave out of here with one thought in your mind. I'm going to go after divine inspiration. I'm going to go after that which only God can supply, and it's going to be miraculous. And especially you get to put this to the test when you're about to fall down from being tired or when you're overwhelmed with sickness. I'm telling you, the first time I stepped into a realm of being able to touch divine help for myself, I was so sick and so weak with the flu that my whole body was aching. My eyelids ached. My fingernails ached. Everything ached. My teeth ached, everything, my hair ached, everything ached. I got nerves where there were no nerves. I was aching, and all of a sudden I heard in my spirit, and Jacob arose and leaned upon his staff and worshiped the Lord. He was dying, but he arose and leaned upon his staff and worshiped the Lord, and then I recognized how many more years he lived after that. And so I got up. That's with all this expression, grunts, just trying to stand. I kid you not. It was like, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I mean, it's the energy and the power of God hit me. A siren went off, man. I was immediately, divinely, instantaneously healed from the crown of my head, soles of my feet, because I was not going to lay there any longer. And people, we go through things. I'm telling you, if you understand, people will sell out and compromise and make a deal with the devil and make a deal with all these things that are far short of what God has said and promised. He told us, if we'll petition Him, if we'll ask, He will surely answer more than an unrighteous judge, more than a friend that doesn't want to get up because he's in bed. Come on, people. Quit being lazy. Get so passionate about God, Christ Jesus, being revealed through you. Because that is a greater expression than to say, I want more anointing. We understand And I say that, Lord, increase the anointing in my life. But it's always in this context, Lord Jesus, I want you to be revealed. Your glory, your presence, your power, your love, your working, your divine authority. Holy Ghost, I want you to be revealed in my life. I want to just be everything that you are. And I know that you come in a good way. Everything that you are in your character, in your nature, in your authority, in your power. That should be motive enough, people. The faith realm will cause us to begin to realize that what we're doing is not in vain. That there is a major consequence. There is a great reward. He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. For me in my life, there was a period of time where that was my... You know, there's different times. If you'll talk to me, I'll say, oh, here's your scripture. You need to put that one up. Because, you know, we'll just get right in on what's going on in your life. Oh, here's your scripture. It's your remedy. I just put up Hebrews 11:6. For without faith it is impossible to please God. This is many years ago. It's when I was 23 years old. Without faith it's impossible to please God. Because they that come to God must believe that He exists. I was sitting in listen to this. This just happened to me recently. I was sitting in a meeting. Once again, I was tired. It's kind of in a state of being. I was tired. I was feeling nothing. I felt no anointing. And I've got to preach and minister. I'm feeling nothing. Dud. Don't know what I'm going to preach about. No inspiration. Anybody ever been there? How many of you stay there? Go ahead and raise your hand. Go ahead. Yeah, I know about this. I know about it. I know about having no inspiration and just staying there, being good with it. So I'm sitting there, no inspiration, feel no anointing, no manifest presence of the Lord. And suddenly, I said in my spirit, I said it like this. Actually, I said, verbalize it. I said, Lord, I know that you exist and that you hear. Boom, as soon as I said that. I'm telling you, as soon as I acknowledged him, I'm telling you, I'm the glory. It was all I could do to sit in that seat because I was busting loose with the power of God. You talk about I had more sermons that could be preached in a single night. Huh? I have found just waiting on God, just agreeing with God. There's key things. Lord, I recognize I'm not going to go with my circumstance. I'm not going to go with what I feel. I'm not going to go with my situation. I'm going to go with the principle and the reality of that which really exists, because what I'm feeling and what I'm seeing is not necessarily real at all, and more than likely it isn't. Yes, we may have all these various different things that are around us. They're real and they're tangible. It's our perception of them that is entirely wrong. You should have been convinced after going through 12 years of school. Huh? Are you listening to me? Most of what you saw, you got wrong. Huh? Are you listening to me? It was at like 70% on your paper. It says 30% of what you thought was going on wasn't happening. Huh? Right? 30% of what you thought you absolutely remembered, right, was completely wrong. Are you with me? We should get it, but we don't. We don't. Especially when you know you're in a conversation with somebody, you got a photographic memory, even if it was 20 years ago. You know, nobody does. It's just everybody's got to mellow out and just get real and start, get rid of all of that nonsense and humble yourself and start taking on the nature and the character of God. But when you begin to live with the principles of the Word and you begin to speak that truth just like He described it, that's all I did. I lived under a principle that brought me somewhere. Father, I know, even though I don't see a measurable result, I know that you're a rewarder of those who diligently seek you. I used to preach that sermon a lot. I'm talking to myself. I'm talking out of the realms of inspiration. I'm talking about what God's telling me, and I know everybody else is going to benefit from it. So same with you. You need to start talking about what God's telling you, huh? Yeah. For the most part. I mean, there's some things He's telling you you just want to keep to yourself. Hey, man. Hallelujah. Find those things in your life. The truth, because he's going to come moving it. Lord, I know that you are. I know that you exist and that you hear. Because we could say, they that come to God must believe that he is or that he exists.
and that he's a rewarder of diligently of those who diligently seek him. But we could just leave the exist. He's up in heaven somewhere, and I'm away down here. He's away over there, and I'm away over here. He's on the east side, I'm on the west side. Twain never meet. No, but he's here. He's here. Hallelujah. I believe one of the best things that God's people can do for inspiration is just start thanking the Holy Ghost that he's with you and in you. And just go both. Go, Lord, Holy Spirit, I thank you that you're with me and in me. Holy Spirit, I thank you that you're in me and with me. Holy Spirit, I thank you that you're all around me. This is amazing. Lord, I just want to understand this more. I want to know this more. And I thank you for your revelation so that I can see it. You know what? Ephesians chapter 1, verse 18. Really, those verse scriptures like that, I didn't memorize them really. I just prayed to them, Lord, open up the eyes of my understanding. Lord, give me the spirit of wisdom and revelation so that I can see, so that I can, my eyes can be open, so that I can see the riches of the inheritance that you have in me, so that I can understand and realize the exceeding great, this great power that has been given to me when you raised Jesus from the dead. I want this, oh God. You think Father doesn't hear that? He hears it instantly. He hears it instantly. 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 And they were all busy like in the throne room, and then all of a sudden they heard you saying that, and everybody turned and looked at you going, and they're all looking at each other going, maybe, perhaps, you think? Could it be that this isn't just a flash in the pan? That this isn't just going to be, you know, the roller coaster thing again? But this is getting in the rocket and staying straightened up. Amen. Hallelujah. We're off the roller coaster and into the rocket. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Hato Bodhi. Yeah. Woo! Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I tell you, dear people, you just begin to lift up your voice. Just tell the Lord, you just say, Lord, I'm going to lift up my voice and shout unto you. You say something like that. That's truth. It summons the Holy Ghost to rise up on the inside of you. Woo! I'm telling you, it summons him. Ha! Rise up, oh God! It does. Now, the more you give yourself to this realm, people, it's just like anything else, the easier the flow. You take off a couple of weeks and you're back to this, the pump. That's right. The hand pump. First comes puffs of smoke, right? Little rust dripping. But it's all kind of, you know, rusty water, dust, bugs. Let the river flow. Let the surges of heaven go. Hallelujah. Everybody stand with me, would you please? Listen, here is something that you do, and I pray in Jesus' name that you'll do it. No matter where you're at, no matter what you're going through, no matter what's taking place in your life, you know, and for me, there was a time in my life where I gave this as a mandate to this church, and I'm telling you right now, God, the Holy Spirit honored it. That no matter where you're at, no matter what you're going through, you just lift your hands towards heaven, and when you do, the Spirit of the Lord, the anointing will come upon you. Woo! And I promise you, it's true. Amen. That's good. That's good, Judah. Let that praise come forth in the mouths of babes and sucklings. Oh God, thou hast perfected praise. Hallelujah. 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 Rababaya. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Mandariaya. Hallelujah. Samrabataya la manjasa. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let Haramondeya. Let. Lataya shaya baya taya rokaya. Yeah, let manjaya paya salamonaha. Yeah, let manjaya paya sakataya loma soya rama manayeo po. Say manaya. You just let. Ha ha ha. Ha manaya. Manaya Moses. You let the lifting of your hands be as the evening and the morning sacrifice. Don't you let those hands hang down. Don't you let it hang down. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. You strengthen those feeble knees. Huh? You let that which is lame be healed, lest it turn you out of the way. You come and you learn how to enjoy the presence of God. Right here in the school of the Spirit, right here in the church service, you just make it, you demand of yourself, you grab yourself by the nape of the neck and you say, you listen here, you're going to learn how, you get over here, you're going to learn how to enjoy yourself, hallelujah, in the presence of the Lord. Ha ha. Hallelujah. 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 You learn how to shout to God with a voice of triumph. Yeah. Yeah. Ha ha. Ha ha. Ha ha. You learn how to clap your hands, all ye people. Ooh, Zara, you learn how to clap your hands, all ye people. Zusatakaya mana naya mana shaprataya mandolo boshe. Now, you listen to me. The same living God that gave these things to me and gave it to those that came before us, that lived before us in the generations that have passed, He will do the same thing for you. You begin to seek Him. You begin to break through the hindrances and the barriers. Many of those hindrances and barriers are nothing other than physical and emotional things, issues that you're going on, that's going on in your life that you've allowed to dominate and control you. And you turn yourself over to a place where you say, Holy Spirit, I'm going to learn how to be dominated and I'm going to learn how to be controlled by you. I'm going to make spiritual things bigger in my life than natural and physical things. I'm going to come and seek you while you may be found. I'm going to seek your presence forevermore. I'm going to seek your face continually. I'm going to obey you, God. Hallelujah. I'm going to learn how to let your glory flow through my emotions and my passions. I'm going to learn how to let your love overwhelm me, your joy overwhelm me. I'm going to learn how to let Christ Jesus be revealed in me. I'm going to learn how to be endued with the power of Christ Jesus. I'm going to learn how to put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh. I'm going to learn how to let the Holy Ghost be manifested to me and through me. I promise you that the things that God is earnest to see in the church, called the maturing and the maturation of the saints, will begin to take place in your life, and you'll step into mature giftings and expressions of the heart and mind of the Spirit. You'll begin to declare those things and do those things that are right, that outworking of the ministry of Jesus through your very own life and hands and mouth. Let me promise you, you don't give yourself to these things and you will have none of them. You don't give yourself to this. It isn't going to happen. You're going to get touched. You're going to get blessed in a revival meeting, but it ain't going to go home with you. You hear me? You're going to get touched. You're going to get blessed because there's an anointing on somebody's life, but it ain't going to be in your living room 2 days from then. But when you begin to seek God, when you begin to put these things foremost in your life and you break through the barriers and the challenges and the resistance and the hindrance, not only does the manifest presence and the glory of God begin to be developed just personally and individually, but then you begin to be able to take those things that are ministered in the house of God and through the anointing, and you're able now to absorb them, and you're able now to appropriate them and move in them and them have effectiveness and expression through your life. And the growth is truly is a rocket ship. Hallelujah. 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 And let me just say this. It's a divine rocket ship. It doesn't run out of boosters. Hallelujah. And my Goliath, it just keeps one stage to the next, the higher heights, the deeper depths. Amen. Hallelujah. Woo! Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You know, there for a while, every morning, my wife and I used to do it, but every morning we were getting up and we would just dance around. You know, I just feel so much joy watching her dance around while I'm dancing around. You can't dance around in the things of the Spirit, huh? Hotaya Messiah. You know where I first got that? That's what Wigglesworth did. And I wanted to have what he had going on in his life, so I'm going to imitate him. Huh? That's what you do. Praise God. He danced around. He got up and danced around, shouted and praised God and had communion. That's how he woke up in the morning. Whoo, hallelujah. How do you wake up in the morning? Don't you allow the cares of this life to begin to take control of your thinking with the stress and the workload and the job task. That'll come later. You just throw that stuff away and say, Holy Ghost, teach me to be sensitive to you. I want you to take control of my life. I'm going to live fully for you. I recognize this day is something that you created. It's holy. It's sacred to you. There are so many things that you want to establish in my life that you want to teach me, that you want to train me. I want to be a good student. I want to pay attention first to you. I want what you've got for my life first and foremost. Get that straight because you're speaking to him. It's a relationship. That will continue to get stronger. Just these things aren't difficult. And then all the rest, all that one motayata, and onesiyatota, the expressions of the Holy Ghost in gifts, hanitoba, and the expressions of the basiliana and the mosirata and the kinestiko, and the character and nature of God, it just happens. It's just there. Huh? And you find yourself protected, huh? Because he's your provider and your protector and your perfecter. And you find yourself not swayed by the things that used to just take you away. You would hardly have any defense against them. Oh, huh? But now, because God the Holy Ghost has brought heaven and he sits upon the throne of your life, ruling with dominion over your emotions and your passions, which you gave over to him because you allowed him to take control of them and begin to search through them. Oh, namat. Then, in obeying his word and keeping his charge, which is to walk in the Spirit, huh, and move with the Holy Ghost, you have days of heaven upon the earth. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, praise God. Hey, Talia. Halamande. Praise the name of Jesus. Ooh. Find a bunch of people around you, hug them, tell them that you love them. Just don't stop. Just keep going. Just keep going. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, everybody, for coming tonight. It's always such a blessing to me to see people here ready to receive, hungry for more. And all of you watching by the web, by the YouTube, thank you for joining with us. We pray that all these things will be fulfilled in your life. It's what Christ Jesus' purpose to do. Holy Ghost is right there with you right now to create the event. Amen.